Now let me ask you an honest question. How many of you have come to VCON still not quite sure about the decision you've made? Or you don't quite know what business you're in? And you're still trying to piece things in your head, trying to put things together. Because I was in that zone my first VCON in 2006. So I'm just wondering, how many of you feel this way? You're still trying to figure stuff out. You're still trying to figure out whether this business is for you, whether this industry is for you, whether this can work for you. Can I have a show of hands? Okay. And the rest of you are absolutely sure that you made the right decision. That's actually very impressive. Because it took me a long time for things to fall into place in my head. Now, a lot of people asked me, why? Why did you choose to start networking? I still get asked this question all the time. Why? Why did you give up a career in finance? And why did you become a salesman? I get asked this by ex-colleagues of mine, classmates of mine, and they can't figure it out. So, I'm going to break my module up into two parts. The first one is I'm going to logically explain to you why I chose this. Okay? Now, can I ask you a fundamental question? I shared the same subject in Malaysia, in Penang. And that is, how many of you think that technology actually adds value to your life? You know technology, right? We live in a tech world today. Information on the fingertips. You have apps for everything under the sun. Right? So how many of you think that technology is a good thing and it basically, you know, enriches our life as a society? Because we live in the technology age. Right? So let me be a contrarian. You know what a contrarian is? Let's look at it from another perspective. Technology. Is it a good thing or a bad thing? It's good. It simplifies your life. Correct? So, 2 years ago, in a place called Davos, in Switzerland, where they have the World Economic Forum, and our visionary and founder, Dato Sri Vijay, often speaks at the World Economic Forum, as you know. Yeah? It's where the finest minds of the planet come together and pretty much discuss the future trends, the trend for the next 5 years, 10 years. These people are the movers and shakers. And the hot discussion at Davos were two things. The first, is technology good or bad? So, I want you to, for a minute, think about it. Because all of you have a phone, right? So pull out your phone for a second. All of your smartphones, right? Pull out your phone. Average would be 20 to 50 applications on your phone, many of which are preloaded by the manufacturer. The rest of which you download. True? Now I want to give you the contrarian view about technology and its impact on society. So today you have something called WhatsApp, which the whole world uses. Yeah? Until tomorrow when we launch a new app, which Chief will talk about, but let's talk about WhatsApp for now. So WhatsApp gives every person with data the ability to message another person for free, and it gets delivered real time. How much better can it get? Including pictures, correct? Messages, real time. That one app by itself has put the postal service out of business. Think about it. When is the last time you went to the post office and mailed something? Never. When I was a kid, Christmas and Diwali card, I used to go with my mom, and my job was to put the stamps on the envelope. And then we had two drop boxes, one for, there were three. I used to live in Mumbai, so one were Mumbai mail, one was India mail, one was overseas mail. And all three post boxes were different colors. Younger people in the crowd probably have never been to a post office in their life. True or not? My banking app. I was leaving for Russia a few months ago, and my sister sent me a message and told me, "Mom needs some money." I was in my I was with my seatbelt on in the plane, about to take off for Moscow, and I got into my banking app and I wired my mom money in under 90 seconds. Her account is registered, five clicks, boom, 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 money sent. Got the confirmation, took a screenshot, WhatsApped it to my sister. And by the time I was putting my phone off, my mom had already got the SMS message that the money had been credited to her account. Isn't that fantastic? But I want you to think, how many banking jobs has online banking cost? Today when you call your bank, you die to even speak to a person, right? For this press one, for this press two, everything is automated. So we live in a world of automation, real time, everything happens, click, click, click. But what cost? What's it actually costing society? Jobs. Everything is becoming automated. True or not? The stockbroker. Think about it. When I started my banking career, I used to call a broker. He would put a trade in, buy, sell. Today, it's online. Robotic trading. Artificial intelligence. No human error. True or not? Through your banking app, the information of a registered account is stored. When you click on it, there can be no mistake. If you go to a branch and you fill out the form, you can fill out, make a spelling mistake. True or not? The person sending the wire can make a mistake. This is automated. Artificial intelligence today is taking over several industries. But for the layman, he thinks life is getting easier. True or not? What happened to the travel agent? Today, do you go to a travel agent? Or do you book everything online? Yourself. A hotel booking. We have TripSaver. What's TripSaver? TripSavers put the travel agent out of business. Who calls a travel agent anymore? The only time I call a travel agent is when I'm lazy and I pick up the phone. So we live in a world where automation and artificial intelligence is taking over. Now, do you have the McKinsey numbers? Mohit? This is a company called McKinsey. I started my career working at this company. McKinsey has estimated that this will be the impact on the following sectors. Job impact. Artificial intelligence and robotics, which is also a form of automation. Do you understand what those numbers mean? Look at it. Scary, isn't it? Some of the sectors, you didn't even think it was possible for artificial intelligence to do the work. So I can go on all day talking about this. Now, let's take it one step further. Artificial intelligence is software, right? Now let's take it to the next level, which is the hardware. Good old elbow grease, human, sweat and blood. We are in the robot age now. Robots today can thread a needle at the first shot. Today plants are automated. Robots build half your car. And think about it, how much more cost effective a robot is. Do you have to pay a robot for health benefits? No. Do you have to pay a robot a pension? Disability? And a robot can work harder than a human being. Now, is this a good thing or a bad thing? It's very good for business. But it's very bad for ordinary society. So my first message to you tonight, my dear brothers and sisters, is for you to wake up. Wake up, because we live in a time where the job market is going to be decimated. Absolutely decimated. You saw the numbers. McKinsey know what they're talking about. This is the impact. Now, if you were in grade 10 or grade 8 or whatever, when you learned economics runs on two parameters, supply and demand. Correct or not? True? So we live in a planet where the population is increasing, but the job market is shrinking. Now, you don't have to be a PhD or an economist to figure out what's happening. The reason why you're sitting here today is because many of you would not have considered network marketing as an option. Maybe even 5 years ago. But when somebody showed you the plan, you realized your life was not getting easier. You're struggling to basically remain where you are. You understand what I mean? You're paddling hard upstream just to remain where you are. So those of you who are not sure, I can tell you, there's more than an 80 to 90% chance that in a few years' time, you probably won't have a choice. Because it's really scary. I know about you, I'm scared. Today, okay, let's look at it this way. What would a person do if they were really down and out? I mean, worst case scenario, lose your job, Driver cab? Maybe driver cab? Driver taxi? At least put food on the table. Correct? We already have driverless cars. You know this? They call it driver assist, but actually it drives itself. They're scared to release this technology too soon because it will absolutely decimate society as we know it. A robot can do the job of your maid in the house, clean your house while you're sleeping at night. You see this in the movies, but it's reality today. What you saw in movies 20 years ago, today is reality, right? So the world is changing. The question is, are you changing? Because all of us have been educated with the old system. The old system is go to work, come home, go to work, come home, go to work, come home. Go to work, come home works. As long as you can go to work, what if you can't go to work? What if there's no work? Then what happens to you? What happens? And today, people who are senior are under the most threat. People who are earning good wages are actually more in danger of losing their jobs than ordinary employee. It's called right sizing, all kinds of stuff. So, these are the times that we live in. And I'm here to give you a wake-up call. So this is the doom and gloom part of my talk. Now, what is the solution? The only solution that is available to the ordinary man and woman on the street is the industry of network marketing. It is. Think about it. No matter how bad your life gets, there are certain things in your life that are non-negotiable. True or not? You need clean drinking water. Correct? You need to go on the occasional holiday. Your health is important. And all of us want to look as good as we can possibly look. Correct? And the whole economy of the planet survives on something called consumption. Do you understand? Consumption. You consume. The rich become rich through our consumption. Reliance. All the big companies in the world survive because we spend money on their products and services. Right or wrong? So what is QNET? QNET is this wonderful platform we have. Thanks to the vision of Dato Sri Vijay and Japadas Bismarck and the other V partners, we have this amazing platform. And this platform gives us the ability to empower a consumer. An ordinary consumer like you and me today has the ability to become an entrepreneur, a business person, without having to go through the headache and pain of setting up a business. It is literally like plug and play. Do you understand? And the kind of commission that you can earn through promoting services and products through this amazing platform that spans across tens of countries. Logistics, supply chain management, manufacturing, customer support, certification, payment gateway, online security, all this is taken care of. But each and every one of you look at this as a small business. Why? Because you bought a product or service for a few thousand dollars. And your mind is programmed to think, oh, I just bought this. If I bought something, it can't be a business. Because in your mind, it's not a business. It's a purchase. You bought something. But the smart people who get it, understand that this, from consumer, I can become entrepreneur. Those are the people that come up on stage. Those are the people who are your uplines. Those are the people who are responsible for you being here today. Now, I'm hoping that over the next 3 to 4 days, you can wrap your head around what I'm saying and what we are all trying to say. And you can convert this from an e-commerce platform into a business. Because network marketing is creating millionaires every day. And QNET is at the forefront of this industry. We are one of the fastest growing companies in the world in this business. We are one of the fastest growing networking companies. And the amazing part is this platform has been created by networkers, not by business people. So they understand. And we believe in rhythm. It's no longer about profit. 19 years. Most businesses fail. 80% of all businesses fail in the first 2 years. Do you know that? Out of the 20% that survive, another 80% fail in the next 2 years. So actual
period, the statistics are 96-4. Only 4% of businesses survive after 4 to 5 years. Guys, we are into our 20th year.
We've been through recession, downturns, and we've only got stronger. So for God's sake, don't waste your time judging, evaluating. You understand? Because you'll just be delaying your own success. You'll just be delaying your own success. So this is the reason why I chose to do this business all these years ago. Because let me share with you something. Just after I met Keith, my friend Keith, okay, on the beaches of Goa, it was 2003. It was 2003. And at the end of the year, I fell extremely ill. Okay? I fell extremely ill and I was diagnosed with a very dreaded disease. And I had to start my treatment. And at that point in my life, I took stock of my life. I wrote a will for the first time. And I was this very successful banker. But the more I earned, the less time I had. I never got paid more to do less. Do you know anybody who gets paid more to do less? Youngest vice president, youngest managing director. Guess what? You're now in charge of a bigger region. More responsibilities. And reality hit me on the head. I said, what if I die? The chance I was going to die. I asked myself a question. I said, Dave, are you ready to die? And it's not a question, are you ready to die as in, God, come take me. It's not that. It's not about being a martyr or going to fight for your country. Another question, would I have peace of mind that if I died, that my loved ones were looked after? And my affairs back then were a mess. Do you understand? They were a mess. I was a young guy, man. This is like 14 years ago. You know? So I was earning well, but I was living my life like I was going to live till I'm 70 or 80 or whatever it is. Like most of us think. And then I got the shock. I got a real bad jolt. And I said, man, this is crazy. And I used to pray to God every night. I said, God, please. I don't want to die. I need 5 years more. Just give me 5 years. I started to bargain with God, you know, in my prayers. I promise in 5 years I'll get my affairs in order. In 5 years, I'll find a way. I'll put my affairs in order, and I'll make sure I'm ready to come. And that was my mindset. And I went through my treatment, and thank God, I was in remission. I went into remission and I got better. But that chapter of my life changed the way I thought drastically. And although I was still in the same finance industry, after I got well, I went back to work, I was conscious of the fact that what I was doing wasn't going to get me to where I wanted to go. Because many things on my bucket list were not money, they were time, experiences, traveling, you know what I mean? Doing things which I could not even think about where I was. And I believe in the law of attraction. You know the secret? I told the universe, I told God, I said, God, I'm looking. I don't know what I'm looking for. I just want something. I want everything. And I want it now. Sound familiar? It was crazy. No idea. And then QNET came into my life. A year and a half later. And when I signed up, there was so much of opposition. Because it's, you know that it's actually an ideology. You understand what I'm saying? And it was, people talk about a struggle. What is the biggest struggle? The biggest struggle is the way people think. We are what we think. True or not? And I found out who my real friends were. Because people who I had made millions of dollars for rejected the business. I'm like, how can you reject the business when I made you so much of money over the years? And I realized it was an ideology. And you had to fight. And we had to fight. And then 2008 came. And 2008 was a bad year for us in India, where we went through some legal issues in India, because India had no legislation at the time. And basically, whatever I built was taken away from me. And I had to start again, just like VP Adley spoke about, right? He had to start from scratch. But every time I built after that, I built an earthquake-proof organization. You understand? The first earthquake destroys your structure, your building, okay. Then when you build your second building, you bloody well make sure it can withstand an earthquake. Do you understand? So then I said, never, I'm going to build this to last. And my motto, I still remember what Dato and Japa have always said, slow is fast and fast is slow. Before you build up, you must first build a foundation. Do you understand? And the most important aspect is companionship and camaraderie. Do you understand? It's companionship and camaraderie. So, I would like to pay tribute to some of the people.
Some of them. And there's a song that has to my heart. And I've asked the EV team to put subtitles because my journey has been this song. It tells my story. They say a picture tells a thousand words. Correct?
And lyrics sometimes tell a story better than you can tell a skew.
I would like you to please listen to my QNET song.
Milan? Sibir? that basically helped me get to where I am today. And remember something, the most important attribute of success is never giving up. Do you understand how powerful that is? You have no idea. You read inspirational quotes. They say showing up is half the battle. Correct? So I would like to congratulate each and every one of you for showing up. And give yourself a hand. Because that's half the battle. You showed up. Now after you show up, you got to hold on to somebody that's going to take you to where you want to go. You understand? It's very important, because no matter how strong you are, none of us is strong enough to do this on our own. It's not possible. None of us is strong enough to do this alone. We have to hold on